Okay, Algebra 2, Chapter 9 Review. We're working on 9-7 right now. We're going to be doing page 522. So we'll start with number 3. Number 3 says this. We're classifying these events as dependent or independent. So just listen through. A letter of the alphabet is selected at random, and then one of the remaining letters is selected at random again. Well, those are dependent upon each other because the first time you were picking 1 out of 26, and the second time you were picking 1 out of 25. Since the size isn't the same, they're dependent upon each other. Number 9. Suppose you have 5 books in your book bag. You have a novel, a biography book, and a poetry book. You grab one book out of your book bag today without looking and return it later. And tomorrow you do the same thing. What's the probability you grab a novel both times? Well, what's the probability of grabbing a novel to start off with? Well, there's 3 of them out of 5. So the probability of a novel, you're just going to multiply the products, which would be 3/5 times 3/5, which would just be 9 over 25, or a 36% chance. All right. Number 17. All right. The probability of S is 1 over 7, and the probability of T is 60%. What's the probability of S or T? So find the probability of S or T. Okay, they're mutually exclusive. It tells us that, so we're just going to add them. So the probability of S 1 over 7. So we're just going to say 1 over 7 plus the probability of T, 60%, which would be the same thing as 6 over 10. Okay, find a LCD. So multiply the first term by 10 over 10 and the second term by 7 over 7. So we're going to get 10 plus 42 over 70. So the probability is 52 over 70. But 52 over 70 is not some fight, so we can divide that by 2. So 52 divided by 2 is 26, and 70 divided by 2 is 35. So our probability is 26 over 35. 25. A standard number cube is tossed. Find the probability. So the probability greater than 1 or less than 5. Well, if it's greater than 1, less than 5, the probability, we don't have to do work on it, it's going to be 1. It's going to happen, right? What are all the numbers greater than 1? 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. What are all the numbers less than 5? 1, 2, 3, 4. I have overlap, so we hit every single one of them. So the probability is 1. 26, 27, 28, 29. We're going to kind of work together. All right, it tells us C and D are not mutually exclusive. Okay, so let's look at it. So I have the probability of C, I have the probability of D, I have the probability of C and D, and the probability of C or D. So if you wanted to put little signs in between, you could. Okay, so for 26, this is 4 over 9. This is 4 over 9, and this is 5 over 9. So, if we look at it, so this is 26. So let's just look. So 4/9 plus 4/9 minus something equals 5/9. So that would be 3/9. which you could rewrite as 1/3. Okay. 27. They gave us 1/2, 1/3, and 1/4. So we have to find this one. So 27, we'd do the work like this. 1/2 plus 1/3 minus 1/4 equals something. So we multiplied everything by, get it, least common denominator 12. So the first one would be times it by 6. So it'd be 6 over 12. Second one we times by 4, be 4 over 12. The last one we multiply by 3 over 3, which would be 3 over 12. And that equals 7 over 12. So number 27, 7 over 12. 28, they give us 2/3, 3/5, trying to find out the overlap, and they equal 13 over 15. So for 28, I could say this, 2/3 plus 3/5 minus, we don't know, x equals 13 over 15. Okay, so let's solve for x. So it's going to be 2/3 plus 3/5 minus 13 over 15 equals x. Get all the common denominators the same. So the first term we multiply by 5 over 5. So it would be 10 over 15 plus, multiply that by 3, that would be 9 over 15 minus 13 over 15 equals x. So 10 plus 9 is 19. 19 minus 13 is 16, or 6. So it'd be 6 over 15, which can simplify to 2 over 5. So our answer is 2/5. All right. So you guys see how we're doing this? It's not too complicated. Okay, 29 looks like this. They give us 3/7 for the probability of C, 1/4 for the probability of D, 1/8 for the overlap. Okay. So, easy math problem now is just add and subtract some fractions. So it's going to be 3/7 plus 1/4 minus 1/8, whatever that equals. All right, well, what's my least common denominator? I have a 7, a 4, and, or, yeah, so B's 56. So multiply the first one by 8 over 8. Multiply the second one by 14 over 14. Multiply the last one by 7 over 7. Okay, so now it's all going to be over 56. So 8 times 3 is 24. So 24 plus 14 minus 7, all over 56. Okay, so that's going to be 24, 28. So it's going to be 21 over 56. 7 goes into 21, 3. 7 goes into 56, 8. So our answer is 3/8. Okay. Hopefully that makes sense. When it's mutually, not mutually exclusive, remember you're going to have the probability of the first plus the probability of the second minus the probability of both. Okay, moving on. 36. A jar contains 4 blue marbles and 2 red marbles. So what's the probability you select a blue marble and then a red marble? So let's look for the first one. What's the probability we select a blue? Well, there's six, right? So the probability of selecting a blue one is 4 out of 6. If we selected a blue one, there's one less blue one left and one less sample size. So then it'd be 3 out of 5. Okay. So the 36 said red. So there's still 2 left. So does this make sense? We start out with 4 blue out of 6. We took a blue one out. There's 2 reds still in there out of 5. So our probability becomes 8 over 30, which simplifies to 4 over 15. Still 4 blue and 2 red to start off with for a total of 6. You select a red and then a blue. So what's the probability of selecting a red? Well, selecting a red is 2 out of 3, or 2 out of 6. And then what's the probability of a blue one after that? Well, I still have 4 blue, but I only have 5. So that one is going to be 8 over 30 as well, which would be 4 over 15. All right, 38. Same probabilities. One of the marbles you select is blue, and the other is red. So we're going to have to do that twice. So what's the probability of it being blue first, and then the probability of it being red second? So let's look. 4 out of 6, 2 out of 5. So the probability of blue and then red would be 8 over 30, which would be 14 over 15. But now we've got to add it to the probability of red and the probability of blue, which we already did that, which was 4 over 15 as well. So the probability of me getting one red and one blue in either order would be the sum of those two, which would be 8 over 15. Hopefully that makes sense. Because it said the probability of basically blue and red or red and blue. So we found the probabilities of both. 39. Both of the marbles you select are red. So, well, the first one would be 2 out of 6. And the second one would be 1 out of 5. So the probability on this one would be 2 over 30, which would be 1 out of 15. 40. You select 2 red marbles or 2 blue marbles. So the probability of selecting 2 red is 1 out of 15. We already figured that one out. So let's figure out the probability of 2 blue. Well, the probability of 2 blue would be 4 out of 6 times 3 out of 5, which would be 12 out of 30. That would simplify to 2 out of 5. So, and that's going to be the probability of 2 blue. Since they're mutually exclusive, the probability of 2 blue or 2 red is nothing more than the sum of them. So that's going to be 1/15 plus 2/5. Multiply the 2/5 by 3 over 3 to get the same denominator. You're going to get 7 out of 15. Okay. 41 through 44 looks like this. I have a probability of H, a probability of J, the probability of H and J, and the probability of H or J. So if you guys remember what we did earlier, we can say the probability of those two minus this one equals that one. So 41, here's what they gave us. Let's just make a little bracket here. 41 gave me 7 over 11, 3 over 11 equals 9 over 11. So the bases of the numbers are the same, so 7 plus 3 is 10. 10 minus something equals 9. Well, 10 minus 1 equals 9, so 1 11th. 42. They gave me 1 half, an unknown, 1 fourth, and 2 thirds. So we can say for 42, so I got the probability of H plus the probability of J minus the probability of H and J equals the probability of H or J. Solving for J. So the probability of J is going to equal the probability of H and J plus the probability of H or J minus the probability of H. So the probability of H and J is 1/4, the probability of H or J is 2/3, and the probability of H is 1/2. You get a GCF of 12. So the probability of J is going to be 3 over 12 plus 8 over 12 minus 6 over 12. So the probability of J equals 5 over 12. So the probability of J for number 42 is 5 over 12. 43. Okay, we don't know this one. We don't know the probability of H. The probability of J is 2/5. The probability of H and J is 1/5. And the probability of H or J is 2/3. So we can say the probability of H plus the probability of J equals the probability of H and J. Sorry, minus the probability of H and J equals the probability of H or J. Solving for the probability of H. So the probability of H equals the probability of JH plus the probability of H or J minus the probability of J. So let's just do some math. Probability of H and J is 1/5. Probability of H or J is 2/3. Probability of J is 2/5. 15, so multiply the first term by 3, top and bottom, so I get 3/15. Second term by 5 over 5, 10 over 15, 6 over 15. So do the math, 7 over 15. So the probability of H is 7 over 15. Okay, 44. All right. Probability of H, probability of J, probability of H and J, probability of H or J. I got 2 over x, 3 over 2x, 1 over x. Okay, so it's this one. Probability of h plus the probability of j minus the probability of h and j equals something. Okay, LCD of 2x, so multiply the first one by 2 over 2. Second one's good. Third one, 2 over 2. So I got a base of 2x. Now just add 2 times 2 is 4. 4 plus 3 is 7. 7 minus 2 is 5. So 5 over 2x.